Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Bioscience Guy. Today the topic is the central nervous system of human being, which includes brain and spinal cord. Before diving into the central nervous system, let's first understand the nervous system of human being. The organ system that functions are regulated, controlled, and coordinated properly by central system called nervous system. Nervous system consists of highly specialized cells called neurons. Nervous system is composed of the following subsystems: central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, autonomic nervous system. Central nervous system is the part of nervous system that includes brain and spinal cord, which controls the most of the functions of body. The central nervous system consists two parts, brain and spinal cord. Brain is a highly specialized, delicate organ which is protected by a bony brain case or cranium. Brain is covered by three layers called meninges, which consist duramater, arachnoid, and pyamater. Duramater, which is an outermost covering, present just below the bony skull. Arachnoid is the middle covering, which is separated from duramater by subdural cavity. Pyamater is a thin, delicate, highly vascular innermost layer. It is separated from arachnoid membrane by a subarachnoid space. The subarachnoid space is filled with a spongy connective tissue and cerebrospinal fluid. The cerebrospinal fluid acts as a shock absorber. It helps in exchange of respiratory gases, waste, and food materials through the blood vessels. Cerebrospinal fluid also keeps the brain moist and maintains the pressure inside cranium. Human brain is divided into three parts: forebrain or prosencephalon, midbrain or mesencephalon, hindbrain, rhombencephalon. Forebrain is highly developed and is differentiated into three parts: olfactory lobes, cerebrum, and diencephalon. Olfactory lobes are the anterior parts of forebrain. They consist of a pair of short, clove-shaped structure, and it is divided into anterior olfactory bulb and posterior olfactory tract. The cavity of olfactory lobe is called first ventricle or rhinocil. The olfactory lobes, which are concerned with the sense of smell. Cerebrum is the largest part of brain. It is divided into right and left cerebral hemisphere by longitudinal fissure. The outer part of the cerebrum is called cerebral cortex. The cerebral cortex has numerous holdings called convolutions. The elevations of convolutions are called gyri, and the depressions between them are called sulci. Both the cerebral hemispheres are joined by a broad curved nerve fibers called corpus callosum. The anterior part of corpus callosum is called genu, and the posterior curved part is called splenium. Each cerebral hemisphere is divided into four lobes: frontal, parietal, temporal, and occipital by various sulci. The central sulcus separates the frontal lobe from parietal lobe. the lateral sulcus, which separates the frontal lobe from occipital lobe. Parieto-occipital sulcus separates the parietal lobe from occipital lobe. Each cerebral hemisphere has a cavity called lateral ventricle, which is filled with cerebrospinal fluid. Functions of cerebrum is the main center that controls all the conscious activities like intelligence, memory, reason, will, feelings, emotions, etc. It also acts as a control center for many reflex actions. Diencephalon is situated just below corpus callosum and just above midbrain. It is differentiated into three parts: epithalamus, thalamus, hypothalamus. Epithalamus is a thin non-nervous part. Its anterior part is highly vascular and folded to form anterior choroid plexus. Just behind the anterior choroid plexus, a short stalk, pineal stalk, which has a rounded body called pineal body. The pineal body acts as an endocrine gland to secrete melatonin. Thalamus consists of optic chiasma formed by the crossing of optic nerves from eye. Hypothalamus. It consists of hypophysis that is attached by a stalk called infundibulum. Behind the infundibulum appear of small nipple-like bodies called mammillary bodies, which functions as the center for the olfactory fibers. The ventricle in diencephalon is called third ventricle, and the diencephalon serves as a relay center for the sensory and motor impulses from spinal cord and brain to various parts of the cerebrum. Midbrain consists of two parts, corpora quadrigemina, crura cerebri, cerebral peduncle. Corpora quadrigemina are two pairs of rounded lobes. The first pair is called superior colliculi and the second pair is called inferior colliculi. The superior colliculi are concerned with vision and the inferior colliculi are concerned with hearing. Crura cerebri are two bundles of fiber which lie on the lower surface of midbrain. They relay impulses in between cerebrum, cerebellum, pons veruli, and medulla oblongata. Hind brain or rhombic cephalon. It consists of three parts: cerebellum, pons veruli, medulla oblongata. Cerebellum is the second largest part of brain, which is situated at the posterior region of brain. Cerebellum is divided into three lobes. Two lateral lobes are called cerebellar hemisphere and one central lobe called vermis. The cavity of the cerebellum is called fourth ventricle. Cerebellum coordinates the muscular body movement and controls the posture. It also controls the reflex action of skeletal muscles activities. Pons veruli. It is situated in front of the cerebellum and above medulla oblongata. It consists of fiber that links the two halves of cerebellum and join the medulla oblongata with midbrain. It relays the impulses from medulla oblongata to the superior part of the brain. Medulla oblongata. It is situated in between pons veruli and spinal cord. A very thin, non-vascular, folded structure on its lower side is called posterior choroid plexus. The medulla oblongata is the center for vital activities like cardiac, respiratory, etc. It also controls the activities like heart action, respiration, sneezing, coughing, etc. Spinal cord is the posterior part of central nervous system. It runs mid-dorsally within the vertebral column. It is an elongated, almost cylindrical in shape and extends from medulla oblongata to the second lumbar vertebra. The spinal cord is surrounded by three-layer meninges. Internally, the spinal cord is divided into two halves, left and right, symmetrical half. The two halves are separated by anterior median fissure and posterior median sulcus. At the center, there is a central canal which is surrounded by butterfly-shaped gray matter area. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to my channel Bioscience Guide to stay updated with more biology contents. The butterfly-shaped area is like H-shaped in which two dorsal horns on the dorsally and two ventral horns on ventrally. Each segment of spinal cord or spinal nerve arises from each side, and there are 31 pairs of spinal nerve which are arose from the different segments of spinal cord. Thank you for watching.